Hello and welcome to this session on JMeter beginner tutorial. And today we are going to learn all about listeners, and we are going to go very basic and see what are listeners, how to add listeners in JMeter, and different types of listeners. So let's get started. And if you have to define listeners in JMeter, then these are the components, or you can say these are the elements that help us to view results. So you can view your results with the help of listeners and gather information about your test. So listeners are the components in JMeter that help us to view our results and gather information about our test, like different matrices that we will see just now. So this is how we define listeners, and there are different types of listeners in JMeter. So let us see the different types. I'm going to my Windows system and I have started JMeter here. So in case you are on Mac, you can also start JMeter, and the steps are going to be exactly same. So do not worry if you are following this session on Windows or Mac. And here I had created a test plan in our earlier session, where I had created a very simple thread group with just one user and ramp-up period of 1 second. And then I had created a HTTP request, and again a very simple request where I have just added this web page, lifecharger.org. And this is the path. So actually this is going to this particular web page, lifecharger.org/best-way-to-do-it. So in case I just want to show you the website it is checking, I will go here and go to lifecharger.org, and this is my blog where I write some articles, and here the best way to do it. So this is actually going to this particular web page. Okay, so you can see the URL here as well. So this is what we are checking in our JMeter. So here I had also added a response assertion. So you can add response assertion by doing a right click on the thread group or on the test or the request and just go to assertions. And I had added a response assertion, which is this. And again, a simple assertion where I am saying check response code matches 200. So 200 is the HTTP status code for a successful response. And then we also had added view results tree listener. So again, to add listeners, you can do a right click on the thread group or on the request, and here you will go to add and go to listeners. So this is the way you add a listener: right click on the thread group or request, go to add and go to listeners. And here you can see we have different types of listeners. So we will see some very commonly used listeners. So the very first thing we are seeing is view results tree. So let me go to view results tree, and here in this listener, let me just run this and show you how we see results here. So here, what I will do is I will make number of users as 5 and ramp up period also as 5, so that we have some good data to show in view results tree, and I will run this. So you can see we are getting the response here, and green means everything is okay. Even our assertions are passing and there is no HTTP failure code. And now when you click on any of this sample, you can see we get the sample result information here, which gives us all the necessary information about request and response. We get the request data here. So if you want to see what was the actual URL that went to the server, whether it was, what was the HTTP, whether it was post or get, and all the headers and information about request, you can get it here. And of course, response data, we can check what was the response we got from the server. And then the good part here is, you have this search field, so in case you want to search for something in the response, you can search here. And also, if you go to this drop down, you can see here we have this drop down where we have text, regular expression tester, boundary extractor tester, XPath, JSON path, HTML, and so on. So the advantage here is, for example, I say reg exp tester, you can see this is our response, and here we have got a field to test our regular expression. So in case you want to directly test some regular expression on your response, you can use this. And similarly, these are some other options. So we will see some of them in the coming sessions. But this is what view results tree listener is. And one thing to make sure is this listener is a memory consuming listener. So use this while you are setting up your test case and while you are doing some validations. But when you run your actual performance test with a load of multiple users, make sure that you disable this listener, and you can do a right click and just go to disable this particular listener. Okay. So this was the first listener, view results in tree. And the second listener we are going to see is, I will go to add listener, and let us see view results in table. So I will add this, and this is view results in table. So let us see how does this listener looks like. I will clear all listeners and run my test again. And here you will see the result in a tabular format. So you can see our results getting here in tabular format. And let us study this listener. So of course, the very first thing is sample number. So we have just 5 sample. And then we have start time for every sample. And then we have the thread name. So here, what does this thread name means is we had added 5 users. So this means that when it says 1-2, that means it is second user's first iteration. This means first user's first iteration, third user's first iteration, fourth user's first iteration, and fifth user's first iteration. Okay, so this is how you can read the thread name. The label, of course, is whatever is the our request name. So this is HTTP request here. Then we have the sample time in milliseconds. So this is how much time did it take in milliseconds. So you can get the time here. Status, of course, you can get pass and fail in green or red. Then this is the bytes. This was the sent byte. And then we have latency. So what does latency means here is, in case, suppose we start our request here, 0 milliseconds. And then let us say we have 1000 milliseconds here. Or let us take a scale from 0 to 2000 milliseconds. Now let us suppose we started our request here, okay, and at 1000 millisecond our entire request went to the server, and then we started getting response from the server at, let us say, 1010 millisecond, and then by the time we got the actual or the final response, it was, let us say, 2000 milliseconds. So the time when we started getting the response is the latency time. So this is the latency time. And then when we got the final response, this is the response time. So this is the difference between latency time and response time. When we start getting the first byte from the server, that is termed as the latency time. So this is what its latency is all about. And then we have the connect time. So this is again in milliseconds. So this was the time it used to connect to the server. So this was about view results in table listener. Let us see some other listeners. So I will again go to listeners. And let us see an aggregate report. So this is again a very useful listener. If I run my test again, now here in aggregate report, you will see a single row per sample request. So as of now, we have a single sample request, which is HTTP request. So we are getting a single row here in aggregate report. And here we get the number of samples, which is 5, the average time, the median, which is the middle time, 90% line. So 90% of our responses fall below 842 milliseconds, 95% of our responses fall below 1690 milliseconds, and 99% of our responses had the time of 1690 milliseconds. Then we have the minimum time taken by any request or the maximum time taken by any request is here. Error percentage, throughput. Throughput is the number of requests per second. And then we have this bytes here, okay? So this was about our third listener, which is aggregate report. And then let us see some other useful listeners here. So let me again go to thread group, do a right click and go to listeners. The other very good listener is summary report. And again, if I run my test case, this is something similar to aggregate report, but you will find a little different headers here. So we have number of samples, we have average, minimum time, maximum time. Then we have standard deviation, error percentage, throughput, received, size, sent size in kilobytes per second, and then the average byte. So if you just want this in summary information, you can use summary report. So this was our summary report listener. And then let us go and see another listener, and let us see a graph results listener. So let us select one of the graph listeners, and for showing you this, I'm going to increase the number of users and also make the loop count forever, just to show you the result, how will it come like in graph results. And I am starting it. Now you will see some dots generated here in the graph. So if you look carefully, you can see there are some dots getting generated here, okay? So this is actually this, if you see here, graphs to display, we have data. So the black color dots or the black color line are the data line. Blue color dots are average. Then we have median in pink color, we have deviation in red color, and then we have throughput in green color. So you can see the dots here, and you can also filter this out. So I don't want to see the data, I don't want to see median, I don't want to see deviation, I just want to see throughput and average. So you can see the throughput in green color and average in blue color, and you can also get the summary here. So you can see the latest sample time, throughput here, deviation here, number of samples here, median and average here. Okay, so this is how you can see the graph of your request, how your request is performing. And mostly you will see that when you start, these lines, average and throughput, these lines are far apart, and slowly they will come closer and they can also cross each other as we have cache developed in the server. So this was about the graph results. And of course, this is again a memory consuming listener, so use this only while setup and while you are validating your test, and disable it while you are running your actual performance test with a load of users. So I will shut it down, and we have already seen the difference between shutdown and stop. So if you want to gracefully and gradually shut down, I will just use shutdown. Okay, so this was the graph result. And now, so let us also see a very simple listener. So let us see a simple data writer. Now this is a very good listener where you see you do not have any kind of UI here. You just have a field to give your file name where your results will be written. So let me just go to my desktop and copy the desktop path. So I'm going to create a file here, and here I will just say on my desktop, I just want a test1.csv file created with the results. And you can give any file name. If the file is not already existing, it will create the file. And now let me also make from loop count forever, let me make one, and let me make this as 10 and just start this. So once I start, you will see a test1 file getting created here. So let me show you. And if you just open this file, you will get your results here. So you can get your elapsed time, the response code, and the success, the send bytes, and all the things you need in a sample result you will get here. And of course, you can see here you have some options. So you can, if you just want to display log display only, or you just want, if you just want errors, or if you just want successes to be logged in the file, you can check these, and then you can configure also. So configure means if you want to, you know, have some particular data or disable some data in the CSV file, for example, if you do not want to see the fields and so on. We will look into more details in the coming session, so you can configure your CSV file or your result file as well. Now the good thing is, if you go to any of these listeners, you will find this file name option is present in almost every listener. So actually you can give any file name to log the results in that particular file. And as I have already mentioned, do not use the memory consuming or the graphical listeners while you are running your actual performance test during with a multiple user load. And actually when you run from command line, even if you do not have any listeners and you just give the location of a result file, it will log the results in that result file, and that we will see in the coming sessions of this series. So let me also write this down, simple data writer. So these are the very six commonly and very useful listeners in this session. Of course, we will see more listeners in the coming session of this series. I hope this was very useful for you. Thank you for watching.